Welcome back. Congress set to get back to work today as the government shutdown enters day six. But will we see more resistance and obstruction from the Democrats?
Yeah, work. Here to weigh in, GOP Louisiana Senator Bill Cassidy. Senator, thank you very much for joining us. So what's happening in Washington? What will happen? Merry Christmas, by the way.
Yeah, Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. Not much has happened in Washington, as best I can tell. Ultimately, the president needs to sign a bill. Schumer needs to give 10 votes for it to pass in the Senate until they finish their deliberations. Hopefully, when Schumer decides that he agrees we need security on our Mexican-U.S. border, we'll be able to go back to work.
Senator, Democrats have acted like they have a ton of leverage in this fight, but considering 75% of most government programs are funded for the long term, what are the real stakes of the shutdown? Is it really as high as it's been portrayed?
It is not as high. Well, not in terms of the government functioning, but absolutely in terms of securing the southern border. Hopefully, the leverage that is going to be exerted by either side is how do we secure the U.S.-Mexican border? And we don't have caravans of thousands of folks coming every other month to enter our country illegally. That hopefully is the leverage. Hopefully, Schumer will respond to that.
Well, Senator, no doubt how this ultimately ends will determine whether or not it is a pull factor and more caravans come. But let me ask you this. We seem to be stuck. 25% of the government shut down, and you're talking about 0.3% of federal deficit spending, right? Democrats offering $1.3 billion. You've got $5.7 billion requests from the president. Are they going to be in the middle? What can they put on the table? How do they get to the middle to negotiate to get results for the American people?
You frame it perfectly. It shouldn't be hard to get to where the president wants to be. Democrats voted for $25 billion for border security earlier this year. In 2006, Obama voted for border security. It's not as if this is a foreign concept. And if you just look again at the caravans approaching with the drugs and the human trafficking, it shouldn't be a hard sell to their voters. So you're asking me, will Schumer move? I don't know that. I don't know his mind. Should he move? Absolutely. It won't be nearly as far as where he's been before, and I think it would be good for our country.
No, you raised the great point. $25 billion is something that was voted for before. That was before the caravans, and we get this highlight of what's happening at the border. Is anything less than $5 billion, which is already a move from 25, as you pointed out, Senator, is anything less than $5 billion a loss for those who believe the wall is important?
No, I think that we have to get this bit by bit by bit. And there's going to be some places, hot spots that we can secure, and next we secure the new hot spot. So I think it would be nice to have the $25 billion long-term commitment. But on the other hand, this problem's not going away. We need to secure that border, and there always will be that pressure of, oh my gosh, here comes several thousand more folks bringing drugs and human trafficking and just otherwise good people, but they're coming here illegally. Yeah. So if Schumer will buy into that, I think we can make some movement.
Well, we should point out that Senator Chuck Schumer did vote in favor of the 2006 Fence Act, which is very similar to what President Trump is asking for now. So we'll see if he moves here in the next couple of weeks as the partial government shutdown continues. Senator, thank you so much.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you very much for joining us.